Over 2,000 years ago, a baby was born in a humble manger. This child, named Jesus, was the Son of God, the Redeemer that God had promised his people. 30 years later, with his disciples, he began building his church, one that nothing would be able to stand against. With his teachings spreading around the region, the religious leaders were afraid that Jesus would cause an uprising against the Roman government. In response, they had him arrested, beaten, and killed. But 3 days later, Jesus rose from the dead, as he said he would. Before he ascended back into heaven to be at the right hand of his Father, he commissioned his closest followers with the task to make disciples of all nations and to share the good news of salvation. 10 days after Jesus ascended, a gathering of his disciples were meeting in Jerusalem when the Holy Spirit came and fell upon everyone there. In his first sermon, Peter, one of Jesus' closest disciples, used Hebrew scripture to show those gathered that Jesus was the Messiah sent to save the world. On that day, now known as Pentecost and the birth of the Church of Christ, 3,000 were baptized and became disciples of Jesus. Around 33 AD, a religious leader named Paul, whose aim was to persecute Christians, was traveling on the road to Damascus. It was on this road that Jesus Christ appeared to him, changing his heart and his life's purpose forever. As a devoted disciple of Christ, Apostle Paul began his first journey out of Antioch, traveling to Galatia, Philippi, Thessalonica, Corinth, Ephesus, and Rome, encouraging believers and teaching them about Jesus. Eventually, Apostle Peter also ended up in Rome, while Apostle Thomas traveled to India, and Apostle James stayed in Jerusalem. These disciples, and many others, worked to share Christ's gospel, the good news of salvation, throughout the world and inspire believers in their faith. Even after the death of all the apostles, the message of Christ continued on. As the gospel advanced, the church continued to grow over the next 400 years throughout Europe and Northern Africa. By 900 AD, Christian missionaries had reached parts of England, China, and Scandinavia. With the invention of the printing press in 1462, the Bible became increasingly available to more than just the religious elite, especially as the scriptures were translated into other languages, including English. These types of developments, along with Martin Luther's release of his 95 Theses in 1517, led to the beginning of the Protestant Reformation and the splintering of the Catholic Church. Throughout the following centuries, new confessions of faith developed as people and theologians discovered more about God and His Word. It was in England and Scotland in the 1820s, during the aftermath of the French Revolution and the industrialization of Europe, that revivalist movements came into being. In many places, dedicated Christians would come together to pray, to study the Bible, and give renewed thought to the Christian faith. Two central tenets of these revivalist circles were the second coming of Jesus Christ and a return to early Christian principles. In the 1830s, this movement led to the first congregations of the Catholic Apostolic Church. By the year 1835, in accordance with biblical precedent, 12 apostles had been appointed to lead the newly established church to prepare believers for the return of Christ. Over the following years, the Catholic Apostolic Church spread from England to Germany, where more and more congregations were established. When three of the apostles died in 1855, there was disagreement over if any new apostle should be appointed or if the church could continue as it was. In 1863, differences of opinion over these and other questions eventually led to the establishment of the new Apostolic Church in Germany. In the latter half of the 1800s, evangelizing ministers were sent to the United States, along with immigrant members from Europe. The first congregations were started in Chicago, Manhattan, and Buffalo. As the church continued to spread throughout the world, the need for apostolic unity also grew. At the end of the 19th century, Apostle Friedrich Krebs became the lead apostle to help promote unity within the church. Throughout the early 1900s, other congregations were established across the United States, from the East Coast through the Great Lakes to the West Coast. Out of North America, the church began strong missionary work around the world in the mid-1960s. This work was supported by the offerings of members and teams of ministers who dedicated their time to travel to and preach in these places. Since its beginning, the new Apostolic Church has proclaimed that Jesus is returning, just as he promised. The preaching and teaching of the church are solely based on the life of Jesus Christ and his commands to love God above all and to love your neighbor as yourself. Over 9 million Christians worldwide have chosen to follow Jesus in the new Apostolic Church, 31,000 of which are in the United States, spread out across nearly 200 congregations. In the new Apostolic Church, we strive to create a church in which people feel at home and, inspired by the Holy Spirit and their love for God, align their lives to the gospel of Jesus Christ and prepare themselves for his return and eternal life. We do this by reaching out to all people in order to teach them the gospel of Jesus Christ and to baptize them with water and the Holy Spirit. We strive to provide soul care and cultivate a warm fellowship in which everyone can experience the love of God and the joy of serving him and others. Jesus came to earth to reconcile the broken relationship between mankind and God. All of history has been preparing us for Jesus Christ's return and eternal life. Come, be a part of this history.